Wisconsin's 2014 governor's race will attract national attention, but another set of races is nearly as important to the future of the state. Those are the contests for state senate. Democrats have to pick up two seats to wrest control from Republicans. Did Democrats catch a break with the retirement of Republican veteran Mike Ellis after his damaging gotcha moment on hidden camera? The Fox Valley seat is a must-win for Democrats. And we're talking now with the Democratic candidate, Representative Penny Bernard Schaber of Appleton. Representative, it's good to have you on the program again.
Good morning. Thanks for inviting me.
Well, let me go back to the Mike Ellis story when this all happened. What was your reaction when you saw the videotape, when you saw it for yourself?
Well, my first thoughts are it's unfortunate that Senator Ellis's career is ending in this fashion. But my second thought is that we're all responsible for what we say and do, and we need to remember that all the time. As elected officials, I am responsible for what I say and do at every time, wherever I am.
When you see this video of Mike Ellis talking about a possible strategy, some people would suggest an illegal strategy to try and attack you or have someone else attack you, I think your response was this could have a lasting impact. What do you mean by that?
It could, because now sometimes it looks like the backdoor kind of work that happens in campaigns and in politics has been opened. And so now we have an opportunity to run good, strong, positive campaigns where we focus on a candidate who we want to vote for, not on a candidate we want to vote against. That's how I've always run my campaigns, and that's how I plan to continue to run the campaign for Senate District number 19.
All right. Does it make it easier or harder for you? Because you knew who you were running against, Mike Ellis, and I think you had a theme to some extent of it's time for a change.
Right.
That theme no longer holds. There will be change. Now, does it make it more difficult for you?
Well, it changes the dynamics of the race because running against an unknown entity makes it much harder. There's not as much to compare. But I believe the people who are considering running will also have political records that can be compared to my political record. And so my job as a candidate is to get people to pay attention to what I think is going to work and to convince them to vote for me as their choice for their senator.
So what do you think is going to work?
Well, I think focusing in on the specific issues of the day, making sure that we talk about what we need to do to help improve Wisconsin and what we should be doing in our state legislature to make sure that Wisconsin is more successful than it has been over the last 4 years.
Give me an example of what you think we should be doing as a state to improve the condition of Wisconsin.
Well, my priorities kind of center around a number of different things. I think we should be focusing in on small and medium-sized businesses, making sure that they're able to grow and thrive, making sure that they have a skilled workforce that's available to them when they need to hire people. And then the next real important thing is to make sure we have customers who can buy the products that a company makes, because without a customer buying product, the companies aren't as successful. So there's three basic things in there: education, good work, good pay for good work, and making sure that we have businesses that are growing.
I think you and I have talked about this, but will the voucher expansion be an important issue in this race, in your opinion?
Right. In the 19th Senate District, the expansion of the voucher schools will be a priority issue. People have told me over the years that they really support public education in the Fox Valley. They would like us to make sure that our public education from pre-kindergarten all the way through higher ed is well-supported, well-funded, and is accountable and puts forward successful students.
Is it fair to say for Democrats, if you have any chance at regaining control of the Senate, that this is a must-win race? You have to win this race?
Yes, I think that I have to win this race, and I think we have a great opportunity. Even before Senator Ellis retired and now, we have a great opportunity because the Fox Valley has changed over the years. It's historically been very Republican. However, it's changed, and the district itself has changed, and now includes all of the city of Appleton, which leans a little more Democratic than it used to. And so as the person who won in a very, very heavily contested race in 2008, I have learned where the Democrats are. I know how to get them involved and get them to step up and volunteer and work for me. So I'm working on that, and that's what we'll do to make the race successful.
Is Democratic control of the Senate realistic? Do you see the way things line up right now that it's doable given some of the challenges you face?
Oh, yes, I do think it is
you
doable.
You do think that?
I do, because the Senate has overstepped their bounds. The Republican majority has done a lot of things that people are paying attention to, and we need to draw attention to what they've done and how they've changed a person's ability to negotiate at their workplace, how they've changed a person's ability to actually go out and vote, and a variety of different things that their Republican majority is responsible for doing. We need to hold them accountable, and I think we can do that.
Representative Penny Bernard Schaber is running for the seat that used to be held by Mike Ellis. There will be a change this year, no matter what. Thanks very much for being with us.
Oh, you're very welcome.
We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Coming up next, changes coming to the 6th Congressional District. Who's likely to be the most conservative candidate in the race? I'll be asking candidate Dewey Strobel when Up Front continues.